All right, so in this video, I'm gonna show you how we can build more intelligent sort of search in our spreadsheet. And we'll be using this data as our source data. And this match score is a column that we're gonna create. But the way this works is that for now, see if I do Adidas running shoes and I did match all. So you'll see that any product from that list that matches all these three words, it's gonna return in results. If I do match any, you'll see that it will return anything that has the word Adidas, running, or shoes. And if I do something like Adidas, Nike, running shoes, and let's just change this because right now we say any, let's do match all. So you'll see there are no results because here we either have Adidas running shoe or we'll have like Nike running shoe. So none of those have all those words as a match to return. But as you can see, we also have this scoring system where we can get like it's 75% match or 50% match or something like that. And using that scoring system, see, we can go here and do match closest. And now we can get, see, it's kind of close to matching this and close to matching that. So it returns both of those results. And we can redefine what those thresholds are using this options table where we can say these are the options and these are the percentages for those different types of matches. And that's pretty much what we're gonna do here. So I'm gonna start building the formula next to this and then I'll move it to a different tab. So I'll go ahead and for now hide some of these columns. And that should allow me to zoom in more. So I'll go ahead and type something that I'm searching in the cell. So what I want to do, I want to basically take all of these words and split them by space and then see how many of those I can actually find in these cells right here. So the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do equals trim and point to the cell, which is where my search value is gonna be, and close parentheses. And the reason I'm doing this is just in case we have, let's say, multiple spaces here, I don't want to actually use those to do anything. I wanna remove those. So that's what trim does. It's gonna remove any extra space in the middle and also before and after if we have extra spaces. So if you don't want to do that, you don't have to. I am going to actually apply that. Now that should take care of those empties. So once I trim that, now I'm going to take this text right here and I'm going to split it by this space character in the middle. And the way I can do that, I can just use split function and go after this whole thing, do a comma, and then as a split character, I'm going to do quote, space, quote. So basically a space. If I close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see it will split this to three words. So now I want to search for each one of these words in here, let's say in the cell, and see if I'm able to find those words. So for that, I'm just going to do it separately and then I'll combine it to a single formula. I'll just go here and do match. And as a lookup value for the search key, the first match option, usually you would just provide one of these. So actually, let me do this with one so you can see how it works. So if I do just Nike as a lookup value, comma, and then click to search within this text over here, comma, and then as a search type, I'm gonna do zero exact match. If I hit enter, well, it's not gonna work because there's no Nike, first of all. But even if this wasn't a Nike, let's actually go change this to, let's say, Adidas. You'll see it's still NA because it's searching to be exactly Adidas for this whole string. I want to see if it contains Adidas. So to do that, I'll go back here and add a wildcard. So quote, star quote, concatenate a wildcard, ampersand to concatenate from the beginning. And then I'm gonna do another wildcard in the end, like this. And now if I do this and hit enter, you'll see that I get one because this text contains Adidas. Now, if I go back and change this lookup value instead of just one cell here to be this whole array, this three cells, And because this is going to be an array formula, I'm going to do Control-Shift-Enter or Command-Shift-Enter to get array formula around this. Hit Enter, and you'll see I got 1, 1, 1, and that's because all of these three words are actually here. Now, let me go change this Adidas to Nike, and you're going to see now that Nike is not here, so we get NA for Nike, but running and shoes are here, so it will get us 1 and 1. Now what I want to do, I want to replace this NA when it doesn't find with a zero. So what I'll do, I'll just wrap this match function inside of if error. And I'll say if error, go after this, comma, I'll do a zero, just like that. So if there's no match, let's just replace it with a zero and all of these will be ones. So now if I wanted to just combine all of these together, I could just take this formula right here, copied, hit escape, go back to this formula, and instead of referring to this range, I can just replace the range with that formula right there, that function split, paste it right there, hit enter, and it's still gonna work. It's gonna give us 0, 1, 1, and then I don't really need to keep this over here anymore. So we got 0, 1, 1. So now if I wanted to get how many I was able to match, I should be able to just sum this. So if I do sum and close parentheses right there, hit enter, it will tell me two words match here. If I change this to, let's say, S9, see, it's gonna tell me three words match because we have S9, shoes, running. If I add Adidas, this is not case sensitive, by the way, but it is sensitive to this sort of thing. I would have to type this correctly. See, now we have four words and all four words actually match here. But if I go here and change this to, let's say, Adidas and S2, then it's only three that match. So you can see we get how many words out of this string match to this particular text over here. So now if we take that and divided by how many words we actually have in our text, we can say it's like percentage match. So for that, I need to get how many words we actually have in the search string. And we can do that by doing equals. Again, we'll do trim to make sure we remove any extra spaces from here, just in case. And then we can just split again using that same space character. And if I hit enter, you'll see we have four words. And finally, to get that four, I can do counta to count how many things are not blank, basically, and we get a four. So at this point, if I take this formula, copy this, hit escape, and go back to this formula, and after this whole formula is over, still within this array formula, I'm gonna do this, divide, and then paste that other formula. If I enter, I will get my percentage. I can switch this to some sort of percentage formatting. So now we're saying 75% of words here match. So if I delete this now, I go here and do Adidas running shoes, just like this. We're gonna have three words and all three match. So we'll get 100% match. So all three words match. And then, as you can see, if I do a different thing like Nike, we'll get 66.67%. Okay, so now in this formula, we basically link to this cell and this cell. So this cell, I'm gonna lock in place the one that we type what we search. So that's K2. So we have a couple of those references. So I'm gonna take this one and do F4. And then I'm gonna do this one and do F4, or you can do those dollar signs manually, it's up to you. So once I lock those references, I'm gonna hit enter, and then I'm gonna do Control X or Command X to cut, and I'm gonna do Control V or Command V to paste right over here. So I'm gonna just move that basically in the spot. And the reason I'm doing that is because now I should be able to just drag this formula down, and essentially it's gonna give me some percentage. See, it's gonna tell me like this is the percent I was able to match. And for this one, see, I was able to match 100%. And then there's another one, apparently 100% of that I was able to match. So now I should be able to use this percentage type of scoring to decide which ones I would like to return in my results But before I do that, let's do one more thing. So if I keep dragging this formula lower, this should be fine. We could return zeros. But maybe if there is a blank, we just want to return blank in those cases. So I'm just going to do that to clean this formula a little bit. So I'll go on top here. I'm going to work with the first formula. And right there, I'm going to say if open parentheses, this cell equals blank, that B2 cell, comma, then we would like to just return blank, comma. In all the other cases, I would like to do that sum thing that I was doing. I'm going to go ahead and close parentheses right here. Another one, hit enter. And now we should be able to just drag this as long as we wish, just in case we're going to be adding more data. So I'm just going to call it match score. And finally, now I want to move this search to its own tab. So I'm going to create the tab. I'm going to call it search here. You can call it whatever you want. And then I'm going to go to products. I'm going to cut this cell with our search text, command X or control X, go back to search here and paste it in one of the cells right here. The reason I did cut instead of copy is because when I do cut, it will automatically adjust this formula. Now see, it refers to that B2 cell from that search here tab. So I don't have to redo all of this thing. So I can now open this data, those hidden columns, and this is my data set. And now I have a score in this column. And as I change this, my score should change over here. See, 100 and 100 for these Adidas results. So I'm going to go ahead and call this search. It's just text, doesn't matter. This is where we actually do the search. So now, based on this, I would like to return my results. What I'm going to do here, I'm just going to add a filter function. And in this filter function, I'm going to go to products and I'm going to select all of these columns except that match score. If you wanted to return the match score too, feel free to select that too. I don't want to return that. So I'm going to do this and remove 8 to go all the way down, comma. And then we need the condition. So as a condition, I'm going to select starting from this same position row 2, this match score column a little bit. I'm going to drop the end reference for that too, just so that you can see this is where those percentages are located. Now, first of all, I want to make sure that anything that's 0% match, it's not returned. So I'm going to say that is greater than 0, comma. And then I'm going to do another one. I'm going to select that same score column. And again, drop the end reference, and then I'm going to say it should be greater than, and this is where we're going to define what that cutoff percentage should be. So for example, I could say I want 75%. Let's do greater than or equal to. So with this, I'm going to close parentheses and hit enter, and see how I get 3 results, and basically those 3 are the ones that are above 75% here. So we have 1, 2, and 3. And now I can just copy this column names, paste it right here. Apparently we have another column name there that I didn't copy. Here we go. If you didn't want to return all the columns, you could just select some of them. Make this bold. So this now works pretty well. The last thing I want to do to this, I want to make sure that I have some sort of choice for this match score. So instead of just hard coding 75%, maybe we'll do a drop down here to choose between match all, close match, do a few different options here, right? So the way I'm going to define those options, I'm actually going to just do another tab here. I'm going to call this options. And basically, I'm going to create my lookup table here. So I'll say option score. So as an option, let's say we're going to have match all, which will be basically if we have 100% match for all words, we're going to say match closest And the nice thing about this is that we could come back and change these percentages if we wanted to, right? So I'll do 75% or something, and then I'm gonna say match any. And for this, we'll do just 0%. And the reason I can get away with zero is because in my other filter, I did that it must be at least above zero. So that should work out. So here you can define more like percentage options and more options as you wish. I'm just gonna go ahead and do this three. So now first, I wanna just add a drop down here. So I'll do data validation. I'll do list from a range. And as a range, I'm gonna go ahead and select from these options this range of three. Press OK, reject any other input, press save. And now we should have a dropdown. We'll now say match all. And what I could do now, I could basically just do a VLOOKUP to match this comma in my options in this range. I guess I'll just drop the end reference for this comma, and then column index, I'll do two, and this will be zero for exact match. So basically what this is gonna do, if this says match all, it's gonna say 100%. If I do to closest, it will basically grab this 75. And then if I change it to any, it will grab this zero. And we can redefine those percentages as we wish. So at this point, let's just go back to match all. I'm gonna just grab this VLOOKUP formula without equal sign, copy that, hit escape. Go back to this formula over here, and instead of hard coding 75% here, I'm gonna remove that and paste that VLOOKUP formula. And now I can hit enter, I should be getting the same results. I'm gonna delete this formula from here. So now if I do match any, see, it's gonna give me any match that has at least one of those words. And since running shoes appears pretty much in all of these, see, cases, all of them seem to be showing up. So if I do something like Nike Adidas, see, match any, so basically it matches Adidas, it matches Nike, we have our results. And that's that 0% case. Basically, if there is at least one word that's a match. I probably also want to test what happens if we just leave this blank. So match any gives us no results. Excellent. Because remember, one of our cases was to at least have greater than zero over here. And then finally, if we do something like this, so match any should give us this. See, anything that contains shoes or Adidas. If we do match all, it's gonna give us those. If we do match closest, then we basically get that 75% cutoff. So if we go back to our data to see what happens in our data with our match scores, see, we don't have anything that will match that 75% other than this 100%. So now let's do something like Nike Adidas running shoes. And see, if I do match closest, see all of this match. Because if I go to products, you'll see that these are like, see, 75% match. So if I also wanted to return all this 50%, but not return this 25, then I could go back to options and redefine this to be like 50%. And then you should be able to see as I do that, those matches are returned as well. But I think I'm gonna go back to 75. You can decide what that cutoff should be at this point, just by changing these values. So you can see I got those results, but if I do match all, it will not get me any results because there's no case when all of these words exist in our search. So there it is. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.